Hi, welcome one more time to this Lunch and Learn. Today, we're gonna have a special training. I know this is the first time I'm on the front of the camera, but today we're gonna talk about how to do videos with my cell phone. Yes, one of the things that I always told you is like, you have to start making videos. You have to start letting people know you're there. And the best way to show them is with videos. And somebody asked me this week, and how am I gonna start doing videos? I know it sounds kind of crazy, but it's easy to say it than to do it. And today I'm gonna give you some tips of how to start doing videos, and especially what you need and what to do and what not to do to start. So first, before we used to spend a lot of money when we was about starting doing videos, especially for social media. A lot of people spend money getting cameras, a very expensive camera, just to have good quality. And it's not bad. You have it, you wanna use it, it's perfect. But right now we don't have to stress a lot about using this camera, and then you have to verify that the format is correct, and then you have to translate the video to the computer, and then you have to edit it on the computer and then put it back on social media, which was kind of hard and a lot of work to do. So now we have our beautiful phone. Right now, iPhones are the best on camera. I'm sorry, Android people, but I love iPhone. Android are great, but our iPhones, I love them. I love the camera quality, like the one you're seeing right now. I'm recording with my iPhone, and the camera is amazing. The quality is good. I don't have to buy other equipment for my camera, and they work perfectly. So I don't need to buy expensive. This is because I had it before. I don't need to buy very expensive camera just to start doing videos. I can start doing video right away from my cell phone. So if all the things that you can use, as you see on the Lunch and Learn, is to use your computer to do videos. Use PowerPoint, you can start doing PowerPoints or just showing your screen and start recording your voice, and you can start doing videos that way. But people love to see the face behind the camera. People want to see, okay, who is this person is? Who is the owner of this company? Who would talk about taxes or which give me tips about accounting? I want to know who is the person behind the camera. So it's good to start doing videos to show the people who we are, and that's gonna create more video, more confidence. It's gonna be better for you. So one of the first things that I'm gonna tell you when you start doing videos is, first, have a clear idea of what you wanna talk. Like, okay, I'm gonna be talking about taxes, self-employed taxes. Have a clear idea where you're going to talk, what you're gonna talk, where you're going to start developing your subject. If you're going to talk about self-employed tax, have something that guide you to that way. So you're gonna start talking, and by the end of the of the video, you end up talking about balance sheets, for example. You don't want to go back and forth and trying to connect two different subjects, because you start talking about something and end up about something else. So my recommendation in this case, because I know we all knew, is to use what I call chuletas. I know it sounds funny, but that's the way I know how pronounced, that's the way I know it. So chuleta is this, what I got right here. It's this little page that you can see with the topics that I'm gonna be talking. I just stick this page, as you see, it's got tape, to my cell phone on the top, all the way on the top, right here. Let me show you. I just put it right here. So when I'm talking to you, it's recording right here. I can see what I'm talking. I can keep my lines, and I don't lose the clue of what I'm talking to you. So this way I help myself, and I have clear mind of where I'm going to. So chuletas, I know Porsche, but in Spanish sounds better. Chuletas is what I'm using. Is when I used to work on TV in my country, this is the name that we had it for. So chuletas is the name, I don't know. So this is one thing that you can start using. So if you're gonna talk about counting, any type of information, just some tips, so you know this is what I'm gonna talk, and I'm gonna keep it that way. So that's gonna help you a lot. And framing. Ooh, Elizabeth, what is framing? I'm gonna be recording a video this way. When you do a video, this is the best way to start shooting your video. Landscape mode. Why? Because when you do it this way, you're gonna have two black things around you, which is gonna look awful. So you're gonna have these two lines, one here, and the video is not gonna look good. So when you start recording your videos for social media, do it this way. It's gonna be pretty good, and it's gonna be better for your clients, for your target audience to see it. So remember, not this way, this way. Other things that you have to keep in mind when you do videos is to have stability. Sometimes when we start recording, we like shaking, which is not good because it's gonna affect the video. So one of the things that you can start using is, you can use your tripod. You just can put in some tables and then pop, it's gonna be perfect. If you wanna be a little bit more professional, this one that I'm showing you right now, it's better because it's tan. One of the things when you do videos, try to keep this just on your line, on your eye line, like that. Or could be a little bit up. Don't do it this way. It doesn't look good. So when you do, when you're recording, trying to do it this way, up here. Not good for the audience. So that's one of the things that you have to remember. Other thing is, with that type of tripod that I already showed you with the light rings, one of the biggest problems is they come in this way, which means, let me take this off, you're gonna have to record this way, portrait mode. We don't wanna do that. Remember, not this way, this way. So what you're gonna do is, you're gonna have a self, you can buy a self-esteem or one like this. You can get this one on Walmart, you can get it on Target, Amazon, eBay. You're gonna take this part out, this part, and this part is the one you're gonna use on your tripod, because this way you can put your cell phone landscape mode and you can record with no problems. If you buy the tripod and you keep it without this part, you're gonna have a little bit of problems when you do your video. So it's better to do it that way. One of the things that people ask me a lot is about lights, about lighting. Okay, Elizabeth, I'm ready to rock, but I don't have a light. They're too expensive. Mm-mm. Nope. If you're starting right now and you need to start doing videos, remember, you don't need a huge equipment. If you have a great window behind you, you just have to be in front of your window like that and record. Let's pretend this is a window right here. I'm close to the window, sunlight, and just start recording this way, okay? Simple. Hi. Don't do it this way. The light is here and my face is toward, is not looking to the light. So if the light is here, my face and the phone has to be this way. The one who has to be not looking to the light is the phone. It has to be that way. I know. If you can buy a ring light, like the one I show you, they are not expensive. They are like $40, $45 in Amazon. They are very helpful. As you can see, the lights on my set is very bright. You can see a lot of details and it's better. It's more appeal for the people to see it. So it's only $45, but you can deduct on your taxes. So it's easy. Remember, if you don't have it, you don't want to invest, always face the light. Always facing the light. My windows is here. My lights is here. My camera is right here. Important. Audio. Before, we used to buy a lot of expensive equipment to do audio. But today, as you can see, I'm recording with my cell phone. One of the things that I can use my AirPods if I want to. And with my AirPods, I can record. That sounds pretty nice. I don't have to get a microphone. I just put my AirPods and start talking, and they are pretty good if I want to use it. Other things that you can use, which is kind of more expensive, you can start doing your own radio, your own sounds mixer, which is gonna spend, you're gonna have to spend more money, is to buy this type of microphone, like clip-on microphone. Then you're gonna have to use it and connect it to another stuff and another stuff and more stuff. I know. And then that's gonna be bring you more excuses to do it. Come on, let me put this back. So my recommendation will be use your phone. If you don't have an AirPods, I'm talking about iPhone, I'm sorry, Android people. If you don't have an AirPods, use regular earphones. You don't need something very expensive to start. Just something simple. Just put it on. People wanna hear what you wanna share. Don't make it so complicated that you decide not to do it and start procrastinating just because you don't have the money, just because. I bet you have a cell phone, and right now cell phones camera are pretty good. If you decide to work with your computer, not showing your face, you want to use your computer, you can use one of these microphones. They're a little bit more expensive. They're around 100 something, 120. It could be more expensive, but you can connect it to your computer and you can do PowerPoint sheets. You can do PowerPoints. You can do a show your screen. You can start recording, which is another way, but people want to see who's in front of the camera. So you can start using that one. You can use your face like today, and that's gonna be pretty simple. Another thing about audio, when you're recording, keep in mind that people don't wanna listen anything else besides your voice. So if you're going to record, forget about your family, your dogs, your people, your cell phone. Ask everyone to be quiet if you decide to record at home. If you said, okay, I'm going to do my videos in my office, when everybody leave, just start recording. In my case, I'm doing it at home, so I ask everybody to be quiet. They do it. They know this is part of my job, so they know that I'm working. Everybody's quiet. Even my dog is quiet. He's right here, and you can see that he's quiet. Everybody knows that nobody has to work. No one can talk when I'm doing this, and it's better. One of the things, if you are doing a video, and by any chance, there's some music in the back, there's somebody's watching a series, like Once Upon a Time, for example, watching something on Netflix, there's a music or there's a something, don't use it. You can have copyright issues. When people put a video with a background music for, let's say, Beyonce, for example, I'm sorry, the one that came to my mind, and you put Beyonce's in the background, you're gonna have copyright issues because you're using somebody else's audio in the back. So when you do a video like this one, just your voice, that's it, nobody else. So remember, no one else but you has to be on the audio, no music. And if you decide to use some music, like a background music, YouTube give you a lot of music for free that you can use it for your backgrounds. If this video is for Facebook, you can search for non-copyright music to put it on your videos. So try to keep it safe. You don't wanna have problems, and you don't wanna have letters and emails and stuff like that. So remember, no music for somebody else. One of the things that you have to keep it clear is to your set. Elizabeth, I'm going to record, but what should I use? Should I use my living room, my dining set? What I'm gonna do? In my case, I'm trying to use always the same background. Sometimes I can, sometimes I can't, depending, but I'm trying to use similar. Like today, as you see, I'm using a little space on my living room that I'm using just for my videos. I'm using my bookshelves, which you see right here. Those are my books. Nobody touch my books. I know. These are my books, part of my decorations. I love the little frames with quotes. So I got this here, do more. So some decorations, I try to keep it simple. If I wanna add more stuff, I can, but I try to keep it simple. So in always the same background is possible. As you can see here, something simple. I don't try to make it so complicated. I got my chair where I sit. I don't like to do videos stand up because sometimes I talk too much. But try to keep it simple, same place. You don't have to spend a lot of money. You don't have to ask people to do a scenography very expensive when you can have stuff at home that you can use it to start. So this is simple way. One of the things that is very important when you're doing your video at the end, don't forget to ask for a call of action. Call of action, as you know, is ask people for something. For example, if this video is for YouTube that I'm doing right now, I would say, hey, thank you for watching my video. I hope you like it. Please don't forget to sign to subscribe right here. Or please don't forget to subscribe. And if this video is doing it for Facebook or Instagram, I will say, hey, thank you for watching my video. Please share it. Please share this video with your friend. Simple. I'm asking people to do something at the end. Always ask. Hey, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I have new videos every day and every other day. That's something that I'm going to give you, show you later on. But just try to ask for call of actions. And that's it. If you like it, hope you start doing videos. And I would love to see your video. So if you start doing it, please send it to me. Post it on the chat. You got my phone number on the chat. Send it to me. For me, it will be a pleasure to see your videos and work you and help you anytime I can. Thank you and have a blessed day. Bye. Don't forget to subscribe.